also geographical barriers, stochastic process, among many others. And the combination of these factors could lead to highly diverse population that during glacial periods, they were in, could be in stable areas, and now during, we can see they are in a refuge area. So I work with Petunia xylalis, subspecies Parodi, during my PhD. If you don't know what a petunia is like, you can see a lot of hybrids in the Hilton Hotel. So this is this subspecies Parodi is part of a bigger complex with subspecies axillaris and subangina that present this distribution here. So we have axillaris over here, subangina here, and we have this distribution here for Parodi. And this distribution, we observe two different grasslands ecoregions in South America. That is the Chaco and the Pampas. So both these ecoregions, they differentiate because of soil condition, precipitation, temperatures, among other things. So in the beginning of my PhD, we did some modeling analysis for these subspecies, and we realized that some areas were stable during the three periods, so the last interglacial, the last glacial maximum, and the Holocene. So we hypothesized that these stable areas could be acting as refugia. We do not have a lot of studies about refugia areas in the south region in South America. We have some of them to Amazonia, the Cerrado, and also for the Atlantic forest. But we see some things that perhaps this region in the north of Uruguay could be a refugia. So our hypothesis is that this subspecies, Parodi, present distinct genetic lineages occurring in two different environments that were in stable areas in the past. So we collect from 20 localities from Pampas and from Chaco. I did a lot of DNA extraction and also prepare my genotyping by sequencing libraries and then the sequencing. Therefore, a lot of bioinformatic processing. We can talk about this later if you guys want. And at the end, I have a file that contains only my filtered SNPs. So I have to remove here 5 samples that were not good. So my final data set has 95 individuals. Then I go for the nice stuff for a lot of population analysis to try to check my hypothesis. So I have around 16,000 SNPs. Then I have to remove SNPs under linkage disequilibrium and potentially under selection. So my final data set has something around 30,000 SNPs. And the major scenario that we have is this one here. So I present the Chaco region, always in orange, in all these figures, and the Pampas in green. So the preliminary analysis show us these huge divisions among the lineages. And we did, we calculate the the pairwise FST with populations. So a few populations has really high FST, around 0.8, but a lot of them don't have, they have like moderate FST. And our AMOVA analysis showed that the majority of the variation is within population, around 57%, and not among populations. So the fine structure and fast structure analysis, pretty cool. They also showed this big scenario about the Pampa and the Chaco. So here, I'm not sure if you guys can see that we have a green line here. So this here are the Chaco populations in orange. And we found this pretty cool because we have a river occurring over here, a really large river. So we start to think that perhaps the river were acting as a barrier. But although I have this really cool scenario, my best K was 3. So I have, again, the populations from Chaco in orange. And here I remove the Chaco populations to see what was going on cluster with 10. So we have, again, Chaco in orange, but it shows that the populations from Pampa were more divided than the other population analysis. And as you can see, it's hard to do this. As you can see, the majority of these populations, they have a lot of different clusters. They were in the north of Uruguay, so the area that we think it could be a refugia. And they present a high genetic nucleotide diversity. And then we started to do things like we calculated the isolation by distance analysis and the isolation by environment analysis, but they both were not significant, which was pretty frustrating in the beginning because we really thought that there was something going on. And we also tried to predict, detect genetic boundaries among populations, and we found this over here, that currently we do not see a barrier in this region. Again, it's in the north of Uruguay, where a lot of stuff happened during the past. So when we tried to see if rivers were acting as barriers, unfortunately, our results were not significant, and we did a MOVA to check if the variation between populations were high from distinct, from populations from distinct riverbanks, and for both rivers that separate Chaco and Pampas and the populations from Brazil and Uruguay, they were not. So although we have these results, we know that the quaternary, the rivers, the dynamics of the rivers during the quaternary in this region of South America was pretty crazy. So perhaps rivers are not acting right now as a barrier to these populations, but they could act in the past. So to summarize, yes, I talk really, really fast. To summarize, what we see is that we, Betunia axilla, subspecies Parotid, has a high genetic diversity, strong genetic structure, and we have, yes, distinct genetic lineages, so the Chaco and the Pampas. We believe that we have this because of the stable areas that were acting as refuge during the past climatic conditions. And what we would like to do now is check, do some demographic analysis, because we know the common ancestor for Petunia is located in the Pampas region. So we would like to check if the colonization was from the populations from Pampa to Chaco and the subsequent divergence between them. So I would like to thank the people, especially my advisor and my co-advisor that helped me with all of this stuff, and a lot of people from the Bombardas lab that it's not right now on VT. Actually, Aureliano just moved to Milan, but I did a lot of this stuff when he was on Virginia Tech. Everybody that helped me to be here paying me. And with that, the bird didn't sing, so I will be happy to answer any questions. Thank you. Always forgot the name of the dispersion, so I always have to do something really stupid. That is when they disperse like around themselves. You know? I always forgot the word. I have to remember. So the seeds just spread pretty close, and it's an annual plant. So I mean, what's going on?
Is insect pollinated though?
Yes, yes, insect pollinated by hawk moths.
Inbreeding
between the populations. We know that Parodi is